Yes, I want you to live to 150, and I do have a plan. And you are part of this plan. And now you might be asking yourself, is it possible? Is it free? What's the catch? And is he crazy? Now let's start from the beginning so you get some context and feeling for how crazy or not this is. When we got hit by COVID, the medical startup I was working in got halted and I've got a lot of free time on my hands. And you can call it midlife crisis, but that time made me realize that I was neck deep in the rat race, wasting all my time without any purpose or real joy. And it was only getting worse and worse year by year.
Discussions.
The problem is that the...
If you don't have a lofty ambition, then you suffer miserably. If you had the choice. If you don't have a lofty ambition, then you suffer miserably. And the reason for that is...
Now, the Japanese invented a philosophy named Ikigai.
Iki means life, gai, purpose. Ikigai is life's purpose.
Ikigai can help us to determine what it is that we want to wake up for in the morning.
There are four components that you need to check off in order to achieve Ikigai.
One, doing what we're good at.
I'm trying to find the meaning for my life. So the first thing I need to do is to ask everyone what I'm good at. You're like the first on my list. What do you think I'm good at? Then I need to interpose what I love to do and what the world needs.
You are good at finding important things, doing in-depth research about them, distilling all that into consumable content that has immediate and massive impact on people's lives.
Hey, what do you think I'm good at? Well, that too, but what do you think I'm good at other people can actually enjoy?
You are very good at building happy in your life.
I'm making a list of things I'm good at. Like, what do you think?
Cooking. Singing.
Being healthy. Okay. What else?
Getting to the bottom of things that interest you.
Being stubborn. You don't want to die early and in sickness, so you're just being stubborn about keeping a healthy lifestyle.
What? All right, thanks, bye. Playing Master of Rhyme, that's a really old friend for you.
And obviously you're very good at picking friends, so. How's that for a short list?
Trying friends. How about we solve not dying with friends by making content to make everyone happy? Let's call it solve aging. So, how about we solve aging? How's that for a lofty goal? The biggest enemy of you and me and everyone, so big and nasty that it even got normalized somehow. But I do have few ideas. You know how they put fleas into a glass jar, cover it up, and in a few days fleas won't jump out even if the lid is removed? I have actually done background search and nobody did this experiment for real, but the learned helplessness is very real phenomenon in psychology. And so when it comes to facing our ancient enemy, the aging process, most people just go into don't see, don't hear mode. Monkeys. Not so smart monkeys. Yet. Why? Because it's just so damn convenient and comforting to ignore the open lid, but that ignorance has its price in decades of life each of us is paying. Now let's pretend for a second that solution to aging exists. We don't have to try all that hard actually. There are multiple examples in nature of ageless creatures. Hydras, jellyfish, lobsters, tortoises. So no, there is no rule that everything must get old. If you would be ageless like tortoise, permanently in your 20s, you would live for about 1,000 years, mathematically speaking. But how do we make it happen? And not just happen sometime in 27th century, but in this one. Simple. We need massive support for aging biology, which nowadays is so tiny that you won't be able to find it in the pie chart of healthcare spendings, despite the fact that it addresses the root cause of most of these spendings in the first place. And, also important, live long enough to see the results, right? Now, let's look at the research tree. What do we need for that? Well, it's like the Master of Orion. We need money and scientists. Okay, let's keep untangling. Where those two are coming from? Government funding, donations, and students. How do we create them? Again, simple. Through the social influence. Granted, it's not easy, but it's simple and straightforward. You see, the moment enough people believe that stopping aging is possible, it becomes possible. Again, aging will be stopped when enough people believe that it's possible and focus their effort on it. Do you start to see where you can come into the picture? You can be a researcher to do the work, can be a creator to make content, can be a sponsor to support the effort, or, which is extremely important, you can be a connector who helps the idea to go viral. Watch the videos, comment, share with friends, all the good social things. The snowball has already started to roll, but it's up to you to give it extra oomph so we all can see the results in our lifetime. Aging will be solved when enough people put their energy towards solving it. So, let's find and connect them. I have all above in a written requirement document and a budget document for the next few years, and they're aimed at creating an array-like organization to shape public opinions, but for aging. And what can I say? With this goal in mind, there is no longer a dull moment in my life, especially if I look a few years back. And guess what? My mental and physical health has significantly improved as well. And you, my friend, can do the same. If you align your interest with longevity, that's what you will manifest into your life. Health and longevity.
Come with me if you want to live.
And I haven't touched the concept of centenarian Olympics and living 200 years yet, because for that I already have a high-level orientation video you can jump in right here. Living is smart, aging is bad. See you there.